好，再看到是珍珠奶茶，一年在全球的商机上看1.5兆元。爱喝咖啡的欧洲现在也刮起了珍奶旋风，巴黎一杯珍奶5欧元起跳，等于超过了170元台币。但是呢，还是让巴黎人心甘情愿掏荷包，直呼爱上这甜蜜的滋味。特别的是呢，法国的手摇饮料店都有灯光美、气氛佳的座位区，所以呢，也变成了打卡热点。而且哦，法国人不止这口味偏甜，像是水果口味的蒟蒻，还有野果更是大受欢迎。跟着主播刘汉竹带您一探究竟。
这里是巴黎的街头，处处都充满浪漫的气息。在台湾呢，我们都觉得吃法国餐是浪漫，不过呢，在法国其实喝台湾的珍奶才是真的惬意。像这一杯呢，要价大概170元台币，不过法国人照样趋之若鹜。台湾珍奶席卷法国，罗浮宫附近商圈，短短一条街就有两家来自台湾的品牌打对台，巴黎人不分男女老少都无法抗拒的爱上这甜蜜滋味。
I love bubble tea. I drink it all the time. I think I have a fascination with Asian culture, and that's a big part of Asian culture, I feel like, so that's why I always go for bubble tea.
I used to go really, really often, like 4 or twice a week, but I'm trying to calm down, you know, because it's...I spend too money on this.
巴黎珍奶手摇饮身价有多金贵？一杯至少4.5欧元起跳，相当于台币150元。38岁的老板 Mark 早在5年前就加盟台湾品牌，当初开店成本花了30万欧元，目前日卖200杯不成问题，让他找到商机，继续去别处拓点。
In the beginning, it was very difficult because the French people doesn't know what is a real bubble tea.So we need to do many marketing and then many tasting on the street to start to teach people how to drink what is a real bubble tea from Taiwan. And then they like it. So that's why now we can extend the market in France.
台湾口味当然也要在地化，法国人偏好水果的酸甜滋味，所以配料区五颜六色，不只是珍珠一枝独秀，还有荔枝、葡萄、草莓、芒果等口味的蒟蒻金球，以及野果布丁都是大受欢迎。而且不流行半糖去冰，而是要甜到像蜜糖。
Asian we like more the grass jelly and the pearls, but the French people we like more like fruit taste, so fruit jelly or the fruit popping.So it's very, very, very like the fruit.
我觉得欧洲人他们喜欢非常甜的东西，他们会加各种糖啊，然后但年轻人就是很喜欢加什么奶盖啊之类的这些东西。很多留学生就是他们毕完业之后在这边很难找工作嘛，然后他们就会先去台湾学2个月，然后之后再回到欧洲这边开个奶茶店。
有别于台湾的手摇饮料店，都是让人买了带着走。巴黎另一家珍奶店则是精心打造宛如咖啡厅的装潢，不但有许多座位，而且灯光美、气氛佳，满足现代人手机先吃的需求。顾客后位满到店门外，想喝至少得等上15分钟，而且口味和台湾零时差。去年爆红的黑糖珍珠鲜奶取代传统珍珠奶茶，成了最热卖的当红炸子鸡。
First of all, you know how Instagram works, right? So I think it's really Instagrammable. So when you see it, you know, you take a photo of it, and that's why everyone knows about it, I think. And it's, I think, really good.
How often? Once or twice a week.
And why do you like bubble tea?
Because the tapioca pearls, I like it very much.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Do you know it's come from Taiwan, the original?
Yeah.
珍珠几乎成为台湾的代名词，比起法国，日本更是为之疯狂。今年1到7月，从台湾进口了5435公吨的珍珠粉圆，比去年同期增加了8.9倍，市占率高达87%。2011年的塑化剂事件重创珍奶产业，如今浴火重生，插旗全球60国，成了台湾外销的经济奇迹。东森财经新闻，刘涵竹、吴嘉文，巴黎采访报道。